Hello everyone, in this video I would like to show you how to fix your electric dryer. So in my case we'll be working on a Samsung electric dryer. For some reason the heating unit stopped providing heat for it, so all the controls are working, the drum is turning, but after an hour you still pull out the wet clothes out of it. So I have a pretty good idea what it is. But in most cases, that's what it's going to be for you. So, there's things you're gonna need. Well, first of all, you need to unplug it. Please do not work on any electrical device with the cord plugged into the outlet. In my case, all I'm gonna need is a Phillips screwdriver and pliers. For the purpose of this video, I moved my dryer to the living room. Obviously, I don't keep it here, and there's a pretty good chance that you won't have to move it much, so you can probably fix it where it's at right now, in your laundry room. All right, well, let's get to it.
Okay, so here we are. The first thing you want to do is remove the top part of your dryer. I already loosened up all the screws for the purpose of this video to make it faster, but usually there'll be two screws in the back holding the top in place. You want to take them out. Well, I didn't loosen up them well enough. There's two. Now give it a little wiggle and remove it. I'm going to use it as a tray for the screws and tools. Then you want to get to your control panel. Usually it just pops right out. You give it a little wiggle. Now you want to disconnect the wire harness. Move that aside. Now we're going to take off the front panel. There's going to be a couple screws there that we're going to remove. Careful. Well, try not to do that. Now you're gonna open the door. In my case, there's only two actually attaching the panel. In your case, you may have to remove all of these. Close that door. Disconnect the door sensor. And move the panel away. Okay, so here we are. Now your heating unit, more than likely, going to be on the bottom. Now you want to take this out just to have better access to it. Some light. Okay, so here's your heating unit right there. You want to get that out. A couple screws attaching it, obviously. I'm gonna take those out. Lift it up, remove the standard whatever support you have in your case. Be careful, don't cut yourself. Now there'll be a bunch of wires going to your heating unit. Well, at this point, I would definitely recommend taking a picture or two, which color goes where, so you can reconnect it easy later. I already did that, so I'm just gonna go ahead and unplug them. This is how it looks like, and well, I can already see some issues in there, but anyway, you need to take this apart one way or another. So let's move it to the better work area and see what's inside.
Okay, so here we are. We got our heating unit out of the dryer. Now let's take it apart and see what's going on in there. As you can see, I already removed some screws just to speed up the process. They're all gonna be right, staring you right in the face. Can't miss any. Basically, remove them all. So your heating unit may look a little different, but it's all same concept. Spiral that more than likely burned somewhere. As you can see right here, I already fixed it before. So mine is broken. But what you want to do is carefully move it and give it a little wiggle here and there, inspect. Because if yours burned through may not be as obvious, but if you give it a little wiggle, it will show. So mine's right here. What I'm gonna do is carefully remove that wire from that little clip that it's in, kind of around the area where it's damaged, just to make it easier. There you go. So this was burned here. I'm just gonna take it off. Now what you want to do is stretch it out a little bit, carefully, both sides. Kind of wrap it around itself. The important part is that the section of before they join together goes into one of those clips so it stays together. Now this is a temporary fix. Like the last one I fixed, it took about 3 months for it to break again. So since you already got to that point, may as well order yourself a new unit, which will run you anywhere from $30 to $100 depending on your model. Now you put it back together, back into those clips. And now it's touching itself. It should work. Well, you're pretty much done.
Now I gotta put it back together carefully. It's all sharp edges. Don't cut yourself. Try to align the holes best you can. Put the cover back on. Couple screws just to align the holes. Now you may want to ask why not just order a new one. Well, probably be a better idea, but chances are that the local hardware store will not carry those. So you're gonna have to probably order it online, and it may take anywhere from couple days to couple weeks until you get it, and I'm assuming you want to use your dryer in the meantime. This will buy you some time. And when you get your new unit, you already have that video to use the same steps to replace it. Pretty good chance that there's more holes than screws, but that's not really a moving part, so as long as it stays together, that's all that matters. Reattaching the sensors. Make sure you clean it while you're at it. You may as well. Alright, and now let's go put it back in and see if it works.
Okay, so we're back to our dryer. Now to put it back together, it's basically using the same steps you took to take it apart in reverse order. So this time, hopefully you took some pictures to guide you through that process, especially with connecting wires. And I'd like to thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe and leave me any comments about this video and future videos you'd like to see in the comments section. And thanks again for watching. Good luck with your project, and I'll see you next time.